Welcome to another practice SAT math question from the Numbers and Operations section. If m is a set of positive multiples of 2 less than 150, and n is a set of positive multiples of 9 less than 150, how many members are there in m and n? So again, m is a set of positive multiples of 2 less than 150, and n is a set of positive multiples of 9 less than 150. So to get a better understanding of what's happening here, let's go and start by listing out multiples of 2 and multiples of 9 that are positive and less than 150. So the set M would consist of all of the numbers or members listed here. Notice how we have multiples of 2, but we stop at 148 because the next multiple of 2 would be 150, which is not less than 150. And then for the multiples of 9, we stop at 144 because the next multiple of 9 would not be less than 150. But the key to understanding this question is to recognize that if we want the members that are in both sets M and N, which can also be written using this notation here, since 2 and 9 don't share any common factors other than 1, the members in both M and N would have to be multiples of 2 times 9 or multiples of 18. To recognize this, if we take a look at set M and N, notice how the first member in common is 18. So it comes down to identifying multiples of 18 that are positive and less than 150. So there are a couple of ways of doing this. One way would be to just list them, as we see here on the bottom. 18 times 1 is 18, 18 times 2 is 36, 18 times 3 is 54, 18 times 4 is 72, all the way out to 18 times 8, which is equal to 144, and the next multiple of 18 would not be less than 150. So if we list them all like this, which is a bit time consuming, we would just count these members, or these numbers, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. So our answer is B, 8. But because listing all of these out is fairly time consuming, let's take a look at some other strategies to solve this problem. Again, the key to recognize is that if we want members that are in M and N, and since 2 and 9 don't share any common factors, we're looking for multiples of 2 times 9, or 18, that are positive and less than 150. And because we can use a calculator, another way to find there are 8 multiples of 18 that are positive and less than 150 would be to take 149, which is the largest whole number that's less than 150, and just divide by 18. When we do this, we'll get a decimal, but if we ignore the decimal, notice how we would just have 8, meaning there are 8 multiples of 18 that are less than 150 and positive. The other option would be to use the table feature of the calculator. If we press y equals, and then because we're looking for multiples of 18 that are positive and less than 150, we'll enter 18x. And now we can use a table feature to identify the multiples of 18. But before we do this, let's check our table setting. We'll press second window and make sure that the independent feature is on automatic. If it's not, we just highlight it and press enter. And now we're going to press second graph, and we'll start at 18 since that's the first positive multiple of 18, and we'll determine how many multiples of 18 there are that are less than 150. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Notice the next multiple of 18 is not less than 150. So there are 8 multiples of 18 that are positive and less than 150. So using the table feature here would be a lot less time consuming than completing the list of multiples of 18 by hand, which we did here at the beginning. So either way, there are 8 members in sets M and N. I hope you found this helpful.